Hey, what's happening, guys? Oxford King here, and welcome back to another Sea of Stars tips and tricks. This time we're going to be talking about the mini game called Wheels, where you use the figurines. And if you don't know, you're going to walk up to one of these tables that you see right here, and you're going to go ahead and talk to this NPC here. Now, I've already beaten this table here, but they're letting me know right now, hey, you've already beaten this, yada, yada, yada. But what I want to show you is when you're in this menu, right, casual game, what does that mean? Casual game basically means practice. It's a practice round. Don't get any rewards for it. Champion game, however, is a little bit harder in difficulty, but you win a figurine. So when you start with the two and you beat this person with champion game, you get a third, fourth, and you know, however many. So you get one figurine, brand new figurine per table in the game. Now I'm going to walk you through how to play this game and what each thing means on the table. Okay, so here we are, brand new game right here. I'm going to walk you through what exactly is going on here. Okay, so when you start off, you're going to select with the D-pad, right or left, to cycle through the figurines that you currently have. And in my example, I happen to have three. I have a mage, I have a knight, and I have an archer, okay? So you're gonna cycle through and decide which one would you like. Now, you can select which side here in a little bit. You can select one on the left side and then one on the right side, okay? And the left and right side are gonna be identified by a shape. If you look to the left of the knight, you're gonna see a square that's a yellow color. If you look off to the far right, you're gonna see a teal colored diamond. Okay, just so you know, that's the shape. We'll talk more about these shapes here in a little bit, okay? If you notice, when you're cycling through each figurine, there is a what I call like a totem pole or like a tower, and it's stacked with these signs or these symbols here or these shapes, okay? And what this means is think of it as like an hourglass or like a timer, right? So the higher the tower is, the more time it'll take for the move to happen, okay? So the lower at the knight, for instance, in my example here, my knight has the lowest to get to the point where it can make its first move. So you really want to kind of mix and match a good variety of what you think is better against your opponent, okay? And your opponent is obviously across the table. In this example, we have a mage and an assassin, all right? And look at their totem poles, if you will, their towers. The mage is gonna have this size here, whereas the assassin looks to be about the same as the knight, maybe one more. No, it's about the same size. So that's one thing you wanna be cognizant of is their turn. How long will it take for their turn to be to go. Another thing too that I really want to focus your attention on is how do you read all the stuff on the bottom left corner and the bottom right corner? What are all these numbers? The first thing I want to show you is this. If you look around the bottom semicircle of the figurine, you're going to see like these little notches here, right? There's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. What this is representing is your XP bar, your progress bar for XP, because these figurines actually level up on the board here. Now, as far as I know, I think level 3 is the max. If someone has leveled it past level 3, please drop a comment and let me know. But I've only gotten these figurines to go past, like level 1, 2, and then stops at 3. And the figurine will change shape and it'll change color too. They look different and more grandiose, if you will, as you level up your figurine. Another thing too that I want to focus your attention on is the very, very bottom here. You're going to see a sword with the number 3 for the knight, and you're going to see like a stack of bricks or like cinder blocks or a wall also has a number 3. If you cycle through the archer, it changes to a 3 and a 1. And then the mage has a 2 and a 2. What does this mean? Let's go back to the knight. The knight says this. It attacks with 3, which means when the knight moves over to hit their side, it'll hit for 3 points. And if a wall is up, if you see my mouse cursor right here, you see the semicircle here and then the semicircle for us, that is your defensive wall, which I'll explain how you get one. And so what this does is when the knight hits the wall, it hits for 3 damage of the wall. That's what that represents. Moving over to the mage, the mage says it hits for 2, and then it also hits for 2 on the wall. And the archer only does 1 damage for the defense wall, but it does 3 damage on the actual opponent. If we look at our health, you see the number 10 here at the top, and then our same number 10? That is our health. Our health starts with 10. And each hit will tick down. Once you reach 00s, the game is over. So what I'm gonna do for this example, I'm gonna set up an archer and I'm gonna move over to my mage here, okay? Okay, now the opponent is gonna hide up on top what they're rolling right now, right? And if you look on the bottom right side of your screen, the bottom right corner, this is blinking. you have three yellow dots here. Now, if you hit the R trigger, R2, or whatever, you know, whatever platform you're playing the game on, you're gonna pull that spin button. Now, what's gonna happen is you pull this, if you notice, one yellow dot just disappeared. And it's RNG, obviously. So one yellow dot burned and you have two more of like a slot machine. Think of it that way. Now we want to look at what did we roll. We rolled double diamonds with some stars. We rolled a yellow square. We rolled a diamond and then a double hammer. And then we have an empty slot, which does nothing. What does any of this even mean? If you focus your attention on the double diamond, teal colored diamond with the stars in the background, this will go over to our character, our figurine, with the diamond icon, which is to our right. If you look at the yellow square, this is gonna go over to our left figurine, which is the yellow coated square, okay? Now, what is the difference between a background that is solid versus the starry background? What is the difference? When you look at any shape that has the background of the starry in the background, right? That indicates an XP up or XP increase for your figurine. So if you need XP for your figurine, if you're lacking XP, you're gonna select the one with the Starry Night background. That way that moves over to the figurine. It'll fill in one. I'll show you examples as the video continues. Now, what is the deal with the double hammers? The double hammers represents your fort, your wall of bricks or cinder blocks, whatever you wanna call it. The more of these hammers you have, the higher your wall will build up, all right? Now, just know that the enemy can go over the wall or even under the wall, which brings me to my next topic. You see all these circles on the board? There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, okay? What is all this stuff? So basically, let's look at the enemy's assassin, top right corner. The assassin has a move that when they attack you, it goes under the board, it'll pop up right here next to the health bar. It'll go underneath your wall and hit you, okay, for 1 point. If you look at the mage will actually do 2 hits. It'll do a fireball that's gonna be at this level here. And if there's a wall here, it'll hit the wall and knock it down. And then the second hit will go over up and really high and go over the wall and hit you, okay? So the mage has a 2-hit combo. If you focus your attention to the bottom of the screen, you see that white arrow, and this is something that I did not see in the middle of my stream. I did not know this. I had someone in my stream point out, hey, did you know you can lock each column? I did not know that because I could barely see the white arrow at the very bottom of your screen, so I hope this is gonna help you out. But you can move that white arrow left and right with the D-pad. And let's say you want to lock in the double hammer. You're gonna hit confirm. Whatever confirm button is on your gamepad, you go ahead and hit that button to lock that in. You can unlock it like that. So let's say I do want the double hammers. Let's say I want some XP for my mage. You lock that in as well. I'm gonna leave these three unlocked. And now we have 2 more spins. Let's spin 1 time and see what we get. You see how the 2 locked in stay there? And then we have the other 3 that are still spinning. So now I don't really like my choices here, but we have 1 spin left. So it's really kind of gambling and RNG, like, okay, what do we want to do here? So I'm going to gamble and I'm going to pull again and spin, see what I get. And now it starts automatically applying everything that you got. So what did you just witness? What just happened? So all like the, you know, pretty little yellow lights are going towards that resource, you're going towards that what's selected on the slot, okay? So let's talk about this. Now, what did you notice that came up out of the center of your screen? Well, we just built our first level of our wall, right? That's that, and it can go higher. You also noticed a blue or a teal light up on the first slot of the mage. Why is that? Well, that's because we put XP with the Starry Knight. So it has 1 level of XP for level 1. You also notice the tower on the right side, it went down 1 time. So the closer that tower gets down, then the mage will move, okay? So let's go ahead and pull and spin right now and see what we get. Here we go. Okay, so we have a lots of hammers here. So what I do wanna do is we wanna look at what do we have? Who are we playing against? We're playing against a mage and we're playing against an assassin. The assassin goes under the wall. So it's pointless to have a wall with the assassin. Well, what about the mage? The mage has a 2-hit combo. The first is a fireball that's gonna come at you at a low level and will knock down your wall immediately, no matter the height. The second combo hit goes over the wall and hits you. So because our opponents here have a way of getting around your wall, I don't want to focus so much on the wall right now. Does that make sense? So understand your opponents and what they can do so you don't waste your spins on building a wall too high when both of these guys go under and over the wall anyway. You get what I'm saying? So let's go ahead and focus on the diamond here and a square. All right, let's go ahead and spin. And these aren't XP. These are just going to move the pole down so that we can actually attack. Let's spin. Let's see what we get next. Okay, now we're going to get some XP for our archer, which I like. Let's go ahead and grab 2 XP and let's spin one last time. And what do we get? Now, we got 2 XP. One move down. And there you go. And now, did you see what happened? Did you see the assassin do their move? You saw that dagger, right? The dagger went over and hit me and knocked my points down to 9. It's no longer 10, it's now 09, okay? You also notice that I have 2 lights that are yellow. That's my XP bar. So it leveled up, not leveled up, but it got 2 points of XP for the archer. And then my pole went down with the archer as well. Let's spin again and see how we do. Okay, what I like so far about this is I like all the diamonds. I even like the square. So look, we're gonna gamble and see if we can't get a couple more squares here. Let's go ahead and lock this in place and see what happens. So there's our squares, there's our diamonds, and then boom, both of the poles went down. All right, let's keep going. We have 2 hammers here. We have some XP for the mage. Now you also want to pay attention to when is the opponent's turn. It looks like the mage over there has a long ways to go before the mage attacks. And the assassin's about to level up to level 2 assassin, which is going to be really bad for us, okay? By the way, when your figurine levels up, you hit harder and you can also take care of defenses harder as well. So just like in the game, the higher your level, the more damage you do and the more defense you have. Does that make sense? Okay, so we're going to skip these hammers here and we're going to go for XP for the mage. And I want to go ahead and start getting our archer ready to go for their next move. So we have 2 slots left. Let's spin and see what we get. Okay, great. We have double square and we have a diamond. I like it. Let's go ahead and spin and go ahead and collect what we have. We got XP. We have a totem goes down and there you go. Okay. Let's go ahead and spin again. Let's see what we get. Okay. I like the 3 diamonds and I like the square because one more square means our archer will be able to finally attack. So let's spin again and see if we can't get something good here. Very nice. Let's go ahead and lock in the double squares and hit your spin button to accept. And let's see where these go. Boom. Now our archer's going to attack. There you go. See, it hit the wall. All right. Now we're going to go ahead. And if you notice, when it hit the wall, it went down one level. Okay. Let's go ahead and build up some XP for the mage. And let's go ahead and grab that. And let's also go ahead and grab the squares. And I'm going to spin this around, spin it one more time. Great. We have some diamonds. So all that stuff is being applied. Now watch our mage here. Watch what happens. The assassin just hit me. Okay. When the assassin hits you, I don't know if you noticed that. When the assassin hit you, you lost a turn because I was just about ready to attack with my mage, but the assassin move said, no, it takes your turn away from you by 1 point. Isn't that fun? Okay, here we go. Let's go ahead and spin. Now we have a problem here. That mage is about to start attacking soon. So what we want to do is we want to double down on our mage and start attacking. So we're going to lock in some diamonds here. We want some diamonds. There's one right there. Let's spin one more time. Okay. So we got 4 diamonds. Now our mage is going to attack twice. 1 and then over the wall 2. And if you remember, it does 2 damage. Bottom right corner, you see the sword symbol with 2? Now look what happened. When I hit their base, it went down from 10 to 8. Okay. All right, let's keep going. Let's see what we got now. Okay, now because our mage got reset with the pole, we have a long ways to go for the mage to attack. So what I want to do is I want to focus on these squares because I want the archer to start attacking, being a little bit more aggressive here. Okay, unfortunately, we didn't get good rolls here. We got some XP for our mage. There's our level 2 mage. So now you see what that looks like, right? Okay, what are they up to? They're about to attack, but not quite yet. Let's go ahead and spin, but there's your level 2 mage. Now you look at the attack now, it went up 1. So now my mage will hit 3 in the wall, 3. Okay, we have a bunch of diamonds here, which I kind of like. I'm not going to lie to you. I'm going to go ahead and accept these. We're going to gamble here. Look at that. That's XP and 4 diamonds. Let's go ahead and lock that into place. It's got 1 XP light. And then boom. You see how much that went down on the pole? Okay. Let's keep going. We're getting pretty aggressive here. I like it. Now, check this out. XP, XP, which means our archer will level up to 2. And you know what? I actually like all of these. Let's go ahead and accept all of it. We're getting XP to the left and a move. Level 2 archer. Nice. And then we're going to have... They hit the assassin hit me and I lost my turn. Did you notice that? So the assassin took our fun away. The assassin's brutal. And now their assassin's level 3. You see the assassin top right corner? It's gold now. So they're going to be hitting a little bit harder. That's not good for us. Okay. All right, here we go. Let's go ahead and get some XP in. Actually, I like all of this. Let's go ahead and spin to win the right column. Nothing. Let's go one more time. Nothing again. Okay. Story of my life, right? Now, the archer's going to attack at level 2. Here we go. Hit the wall. Okay. So we want to take all of these. And we'll take 1 diamond. Let's go ahead and spin. See that? See how it all went to the left? Okay, now we're bringing down their wall even more. Now, the diamond didn't go to the right because there wasn't multiple diamonds. You have to have more of the same shape, same type for it to be accepted. Here's some XP and XP, XP. And we need some movement here. So let's go ahead and start spinning here. Let's go ahead and take this one. Okay, lots of XP for our archer. Our archer's going to be level 3 now. See, we have a gold archer now. Great, our mage is going to attack. Once, and then once there too. Okay, now my health is down to 2, so we're getting close to the game over. But look, we have 2 yellow at the bottom. We're pretty decked out now, but we have to be very, very careful. Let's spin to see what's happening. Okay, we have XP, XP. We have more diamonds. Let's go with that. We're hoping for double squares. You know what? I'm going to take that diamond. Okay, let's see where these go. Okay, we got all that. So that square didn't go because there wasn't enough squares to allocate to our resource there. So, okay, let's see. We need more squares. Look at all this. The wall here. I'm going to gamble like crazy. And we want to stack up on squares. Here's 3. 1, 2, and 3. Nope. Now let's see if those 3 squares go to the left. And they do. And I think we just lost the game. We did. But yeah, if you guys enjoyed this video, drop a like, subscribe, drop a comment below, and let me know, are you enjoying the Wheels minigame? Me, for one, I love it. It's fun. And every time I see a table, I'm like, let's go. All right, guys. See you on the next video. Bye-bye.